Melatonin that helps you fall asleep naturally and wake with no next day grogginess. ZQL Pure Z's naturally superior sleep. On AM 560, The Answer, I'm Tom Beck.
Time now for the AM 560 Business Beat, a service of Matrix Industrial Automation, a leader in turnkey robotic automation systems. Online at matrixindustrialautomation.com.
I'm Liz Klayman, and this is the Fox Business Report.
All Wall Street stocks sinking as optimism fades that a coronavirus vaccine is coming soon. High-flying tech companies, the market leader since the rebound began in late March, suffered their biggest drop in months. The Dow falling 808 points, the Nasdaq down 598, S&P 500 down 126. And two companies that began trading on a split-adjusted basis on Monday not faring well on Wall Street. Second day of consecutive losses for Apple, with its shares falling 8% for its biggest one-day decline since March. And Tesla stock dropping for a third straight day, falling 9%. With Thursday's decline, Tesla shares are more than 18% below Monday's close. This week, the electric vehicle maker announced a $5 billion share sale, and Tesla's largest outside stockholder trimmed its position in the company. That's your Fox Business Report. I'm Hillary Barsky, invested in you.
Balance of nature, changing the world one life at a time.
Your products are great, absolutely. You know, general aches and pains I have from, because I work outside a lot, gone. It's almost magic. It's almost too good to be true, you know, but it is. It's very true. Dr. Howard's done a fantastic service by creating this.
I work in healthcare, and I haven't gotten even a runny nose. I'm walking more. I'm exercising more. I'm doing more yoga. I'm pretty convinced that this is something to do with it. And you know what? I will never be without it. Because this was painless and easy. It's amazing. I'm telling you, it's amazing.
Get a wide variety of all your daily recommended servings of whole fruits and vegetables without having to leave your home. Right now, Balance of Nature is offering free shipping and 35% off on any new preferred order. Call 1-800-246-8751 or go to balanceofnature.com today and use discount code Chicago.
Oh, whale! Guys, whale! Wow, whale.
Oh, that's a big whale. Okay. Whale, whale, whale! Oh no, whale!
The tides can turn quick on the water. Progressive's boat insurance has you covered. Get a quote today in as little as 3 minutes at progressive.com.
Well, at least it wasn't a shark, am I right?
Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates.
So who is your wireless provider? AT&T, Verizon, T-Mobile? The average person is saving $400 a year by switching to Pure Talk USA. Pure Talk is on the same network, same towers, just 50% off in terms of price. Right now, get unlimited talk, text, and 2 gigs of data for just $20 a month. Switch to Pure Talk today. Now, from your cell phone, dial #250 and say Pure Radio. That's #250, Pure Radio, Pure Talk USA, simply smarter wireless.
Try Kraft's P3 Portable Protein Packs, a snack with up to 13 grams of protein from 3 delicious ingredients, meat, cheese, and nuts, because 3 is better than 1. P3 is packaged in convenient on-the-go containers, so if you have a hectic commute or need a boost of energy, P3 is there to help you take on the day.
How can you get from here to there? We've got the answer from the AM 560 Traffic Center.
On Chicago's south side, there's a shooting investigation underway. It's closing down eastbound 79th Street between Anthony Avenue and the Chicago Skyway. Now coming in on I-57, heavy police activity. Traffic at a standstill between 159th and Sibley Boulevard, where that exit ramp is shut down. I-80 up to the Ryan Merge, 27 minutes. Southbound side of the Tri-State loaded down from 80 on over to 8094, where that delay continues east 8094 from the Bishop Ford Freeway. Most of the way on over to Indianapolis Boulevard. Kennedy outbound 18 to the split, 11 in the express, 42 to the airport. Inbound from O'Hare at 46. Eisenhower outbound 52 minutes from the circle to 390. Inbound from 390 at 58 minutes. The ramp to the outbound Kennedy now open. That's traffic. I'm Mary DeBagis. On AM 560, The Answer.
Now, your official weather forecast.
Overnight, clear skies, the overnight low 58. Friday, mostly sunny and pleasant. Friday's high 79. Saturday will be warm with sunshine and patchy clouds. It'll be breezy in the afternoon, the high 84. I'm Drew Shannon on AM 560, The Answer.
Get the latest weather, traffic, and news updates online at 560theanswer.com.
This hourly segment is brought to you by Get Down to Business with Shalom Klein, the show for business powered by Mirabali Insurance. Sunday evenings at 6 on AM 560, The Answer.
While Steve Cortez is on special assignment with the Trump campaign, filling in for Steve is Sean Thompson.
I'd like to welcome you to the Steve Cortez Show. These are my favorite days because I get to say Steve Cortez's name about six times to my name. Sean Thompson in for Steve Cortez on the line. Steve Cortez. Steve, how are you, handsome?
Sean, I am great. Thanks for having me.
Wonderful. Listen, I got to tell you, we're going to get into all this stuff, okay? But I get sent the video. You know how you did the video in front of the board. I watch all your stuff on TV. What do you travel with makeup people? There's not a hair out of place. The clothes are pressed. I mean, enough of this already, for God's sakes. Act like the rest of us.
Sean, if you're not smart, you got to try to look good, okay? That's taken me a long way in life. You know, just be tan, be put together. Yeah. You know, it's taken me a long way.
What happened to the guy in the shorts with the sport coat? That's the guy I want. That's the Steve I love. Where's that guy?
By the way, those videos, thank you for watching. And for the audience out there, if you're as wonderful as Sean is, if you're hankering for a little bit of Steve Cortez, go on to my Twitter, at Cortez Steve, and I'm putting a lot more of these videos up. I call them Chalk Talks. It's Coach Cortez breaking down the defense on the other side, breaking down what Biden's doing, but also trying to promote our vision. And I'm putting a lot more of these up. They seem to be a hit. They're getting a ton of play on Facebook. People like Chalk Talk. It's football season, so at least most places. It's not, unfortunately, Illinois because of Governor Tweedledum. But in most places in America, high school football, youth football is kicking off.
And on your Chalk Talk, you solved my problem. You see, I married the prettiest girl in the neighborhood. But you know what happens? You know, after they get over the old 45, they become the meanest girl in the neighborhood. Well, that's what I got, all right? And she calls me up out of nowhere. She doesn't listen to the show, never has listened to a show. But she is livid about this Nancy Pelosi thing. The reason is she's a hairdresser. So what they did to my wife, to her friends, to the girls in the salon, is that not only that they just took away their livelihood, but in order to come back, the restrictions are so draconian, they cannot move without that mask on. So she wants me to tell you and everybody that when women get their hair shampooed, they absolutely must wear a mask, especially the aged women. And so must the shampoo girl, and so must the hair. Everybody, no one takes the mask off inside the salon. And that's in states that they allow you to go in, let alone California, where you can't even walk in.
Right. No, exactly. So she was breaking so many rules, so many laws. And by the way, these laws that she publicly claims to support and to inflict upon all the rest of us. But you're right on a few angles here. I think this is a bigger issue than a lot of Democrats believe. I think it's a bigger issue than a lot of my comrades at the Trump campaign believe. And here's why. You know, and you touched on it. There are a lot of people out there who aren't terribly political. There are a lot of people out there who may not particularly like Donald Trump. But there are a ton of people who either directly work in the beauty industry or, you know, in terms of customers, are very serious customers of the beauty industry, right? Take their hair, their nails, all of it seriously. And these people, when they see this kind of rank hypocrisy from Pelosi, and of course, Pelosi told Lori Lightfoot and said, "Lightfoot, hold my beer. I'm going to do this on a national level, what you did locally." And when they see this kind of rank hypocrisy, you know, I really think that it so rattles people because we are just hardwired as human beings to despise two sets of rules, right? We hate that, as we should, that there's a set of rules for the credentialed class, for the permanent political class, and for the connected cronies. That they have one set of rules, and that all the rest of us, the serfs and the peasants, we have another set of rules. It's outrageous. And on top of that, I think Nancy Pelosi made a couple of, I mean, that was bad enough, right, that she was just completely flouting the rules. But on top of it, I think she made a couple of other critical mistakes. Number one, she threw the owner, the entrepreneur, single mom, stylist owner, threw her under the bus and said it was a setup, which, of course, is ridiculous. I mean, that's just an absolute sham of an accusation. So I think that also rings hollow to anyone out there. Doesn't have to be in the beauty business. Anybody who owns a business, anybody who's trying to grow a business, the idea that this was some sort of elaborate setup, right, is you know, just ridiculous and insulting. But then also, and you mentioned this, Sean, she is 80 years old, okay? Now, look, you and I are on the same page, I think, as far as, you know, we think that the draconian lockdown and the draconian rules in so many places, particularly places like Illinois, are ridiculous. But if we're to believe, if we're to take Nancy seriously for a moment, if we can actually suspend reason and do that, right, according to her, she should be extra careful in every single way because she's an incredibly high-risk group. What her behavior, her hidden behavior until we saw the tape, what her behavior shows us is she doesn't believe anything she's saying.
No.
She clearly doesn't.
None of it.
She wouldn't have put herself in that vulnerable position.
And here's the thing I said on the show on Monday. The Politburo didn't wait for bread in Russia. They got it. The Politburo didn't wait for shoes or for coats or for cars. They get it. What this establishes is that there is no question anymore. Democrats will live by a different set of rules they cast upon us like the chains of slavery they are. That's why they don't abide by the Obamacare. That's why they don't abide by these rules, which they know themselves are intended to make people stay in their homes and understand you are the slaves, we make the rules. I think this blew the lid off of it. This and Joe Biden threatening us to lock us down again are two reasons that nobody, and I mean nobody, even old Democrats, shouldn't vote for these new Democrats, which are old Marxists.
Right. You know, by the way, and speaking of that threat to lock us down again, I did a ton of Wisconsin television today. So one of the things I'm doing with the campaign, I do the national TV, and that's kind of the sexy, glamorous part. By the way, I'll be on Laura Ingraham tonight. So for the audience out there, I'll be on at 9 o'clock Central Time on Laura Ingraham. And I will be debating Chris Hahn, who's been a frequent guest on the Steve Cortez radio show. I want to be talking about Wisconsin. But in any case, I did a lot of Wisconsin TV today. And I will tell you this. I talked a lot about the threat, again, you know, I don't want to say the idea because it's more of a threat. The threat from Joe Biden, not just that he would close down the economy again, that's terrible enough, but he also threatens that for 3 months, he said at least for 3 months, when he is president, I mean, mind you, he wouldn't even become president if he were to until January. So he's promising us that the whole first quarter, at least, of 2021, national outdoor mask mandate. And so, I, you know, I said this a lot on air today, that if you were fishing by yourself on Elkhart Lake in Wisconsin, Joe Biden, if he were ever, God forbid, President Joe Biden, is going to tell you that you must wear a mask outside by yourself. And I have to tell you, even a lot of these liberal TV anchors in Wisconsin seem to agree that, yeah, you know, that's crazy. And so, yeah, sometimes it's these non-obvious issues that can be a turning point politically. I really think the Nancy issue is going to have legs. The haircut hypocrite. It's kind of funny because, of course, we went crazy on this issue. I think everybody did at our station quite properly when Lori Lightfoot did this. But that was a Chicago issue. The country didn't care a ton about it. And now it's a national issue. She is the most senior Democrat elected official in America. She is third in line to the president of the United States. She absolutely was completely just outed as an utter hypocrite, as somebody who believes that she lives by a different set of rules and standards than the rest of us. And I think it's going to have electoral consequences. I really do.
You know, you and I live in the Democrat mafia capital. So I've been around these pretend gangsters for decades. And I have a certain disdain. To me, Democrat is a dirty word. They're mobsters that can't fight their way out of a wet paper bag. That's all they are. And they work with law instead of guns and knives. Laws and regulations are the way that in which they control that power. And that's why this state and this city is in such disarray. I'm trying to do everything I can to prevent it from spreading. But the more we see it, the better it is. Because these regular people in America, these regular Americans, they don't want to live like this. And when they see the Crypt Keeper walk off the plane with that old lady driving Miss Daisy hair blowing in the wind and how frail he is with the wife that's a nurse, I think this is going to be a very big week for Trump. I think he's actually campaigning for Trump in Kenosha. I'm wondering how you see it.
Yeah. You know, yes. And let's talk about Kenosha for a second, because I think this is pretty important. You know, the contrast between President Trump, his visit there, and Joe Biden's. Joe Biden told us as recently, and I'm certainly going to talk about this on Laura Ingraham's show tonight. He told us as recently as just 2 weeks ago that he could not go to Wisconsin, right? He could not go there, even though the convention was officially in Milwaukee. Not much happened, but it was officially there. But he was unable to travel there and to accept his nomination in person, the way President Trump did accept his nomination in person in Charlotte, North Carolina. Biden told us he couldn't do that. Why? He said because of the, quote, science that had precluded him from traveling. Well, Sean, in the last 2 weeks, nothing has changed regarding the science. Zero. Nothing. You know what has changed? The political science. That's what's changed in the last 2 weeks, because Team Biden realizes they are in a heck of a dogfight right now. They know that we are closing in everywhere, and that's true in public polling. It's true in private polling that we have at the campaign. It's also true, and I'm guessing you'll appreciate this as a former trader, it's also true in the betting markets.
That's all I watch, brother. You could take the polls.
have gone to, they've gone to coin flip right now. Now, it doesn't show us up either, but it's effectively just gone to a tie game, right? It's just jump ball from here forward. So, listen, the Biden team, they're unscrupulous, but they're not dumb. And they knew that they had to try to wheel him out. They got to try to, you know, put him on the Hannibal Lecter cart, right, and tie him to the gurney, you know, and wheel him out there and see if he can handle it for 12 minutes, which is what he did in Pennsylvania. Now they took him there. But anyway, my question to Team Biden is, if you couldn't go 2 weeks ago, why can you go now? What changed? You know, again, nothing changed in the science. And then also to contrast his ridiculous visit with Donald Trump's visit to Kenosha, Donald Trump and former governor Scott Walker wrote an editorial today that I encourage the listeners to read. It's in the Washington Times. And he begins it by saying, Donald Trump literally saved Kenosha. So, and what he means by that is, when Kenosha was in flames and when things were dire on the ground there in Kenosha, and by the way, it's basically a Chicago suburb. That might bother some people from Kenosha to hear, but it's, you know, it's relatively right in between Chicago and Milwaukee. So, you know, it's near and dear to a lot of us, right? When things were dire on the ground there, and we know this, by the way, this is not my opinion. We know this from the sheriff of Kenosha County, from Sheriff Beth. The call went up to the feds. We need help. They sent up the bat signal. We can't handle this on our own. We're overwhelmed. And according to the sheriff, he said the response was swift. It was forceful. It was amazing. And Donald Trump and Attorney General Barr and federal law enforcement restored order there very, very quickly and saved Kenosha. So this is a man of action rather than a man, Joe Biden, an empty shell full of platitudes, right? Through of sloganeering. Huh. And I think that difference has been shown in Kenosha, and I believe it's one of the reasons we're going to win Wisconsin again.
Oh, Steve, I think it's going to, honestly, I think, and Joe Biden getting out in the public eye is the exact opposite of what he should do, of what he wanted to do, and of what the Democrats were afraid of. Because they understand, when you see the difference, you know, we're a visual people. The bulk of what holds the Democrats together are the union extorted Democrats. They're forced to vote Democrat because that's where their contracts, that's where their bread is buttered. But these are men. And they're going to look at this feeble old man walking around with his mask on and his corpse hair blowing in the wind. And they're going to say, I'm sorry, this guy shouldn't be running a lemonade stand. I have this thing. He can't get a driver's license in any of the states he's going to be the president over. It's come right. on. I mean,
that's why he wants to be president, because you don't have to drive. Right.
It's just ridiculous. You know, and they're going to look back and think this was a huge mistake, I think.
To that point, you know, talking about the blue-collar voters who typically vote Democratic, who a lot of whom came over to Trump's side last time, and I think more of them are going to come over this time. When they look at this issue of public safety, when they look at a place like Kenosha, I think they're going to see two things with Joe Biden. Number one, although he has not used the phrase defund the police, he said it in five other ways using different synonyms. Okay, he is for defunding the police. He clearly does not have the back of the police. And again, I always like to say this, Sean, don't take my word for it. Take the cops' word for it. Okay, the Trump campaign continues to collect police, and I mean big police organization endorsements every single day. Today, we just picked up a new one from Texas, the biggest one in the state of Texas, the union that represents 30,000 officers in Texas. And it was an enthusiasm. I mean, this is not a half-hearted endorsement. This is a full-on, full-throttle endorsement of President Trump, and just as vicious, by the way, on the other side in assailing Joe Biden. So I think they'll see that, number one. Number two, what I think a lot of these blue-collar people, who, again, many of them lean Democratic or at least have voted Democratic. The other thing you're going to say is, cops can't always protect me, right? They can't always get there in time. There will be cases, unfortunately, sometimes, like Kenosha, where they're just absolutely overwhelmed. We as citizens of this United States, because of the Bill of Rights and because of our God-given rights, we know that we are, of course, empowered to defend ourselves. And we do that, when it comes down to when the rubber meets the road, we do that via the Second Amendment and via firearms. Joe Biden has promised to put Robert Francis O'Rourke, the fake Mexican, the Fexican Beto O'Rourke, the biggest gun-grabbing politician in American history, he's promised to put him in charge of firearms policy for this country. So not only will Joe Biden make you less safe because he's going to undermine the cops, but then he's going to also then tell you, you can't, if it comes to it, you can't defend yourself or your family or your property because we're going to take your weapons away.
Steve, I got Marcus circling this this studio like I was in, one of the Chippendale dancers. So could you hang on through the break?
Yes.
All right, hang on through the break. We got to make a little bit of money. And what I want to do is I want to talk more about the Second Amendment, and then I want to talk about the economic plan in the future. So let's do that. We're going to hit that as soon as the break goes, because I talk through the break, and you know how technical they are here. Then the computer freezes and all that nonsense. You should see, I even got Jeff here late. His light is on in the office. I'm afraid to leave the studio. But I'm going to say that Steve Cortez said I could drag on. We'll be back after this with Steve Cortez.
AM 560's Steve Cortez is on special assignment working on President Trump's re-election campaign. He'll be back after the election in November right here on AM 560, The Answer.
Friends, it's Steve Cortez here. Let's talk about mortgages and the housing market. The housing market has been an incredible bright spot within the economic recovery of recent months as our country begins to rebuild, quite literally in the case of home construction, and rebuild overall in terms of our economic renaissance from the ravages of the coronavirus. It seems quite clear that the housing sector is one of the leading drivers of that recovery. A lot of incredible data lately, including in July, the biggest month for existing home sales ever. And that's on the back of, in June, one of the biggest housing starts months ever. If you are in the mortgage market right now, I suggest you go to UnitedFaithMortgage.com. They are wonderful people, family-run operation. They're a direct lender, which means often you can get your loan processed faster and sometimes at a better rate. UnitedFaithMortgage.com.
United Mortgage Corp, Melville, New York. NMLS number 1330. Ryan Vrecka, NMLS number 65233. For all licensing information, go to NMLSConsumerAccess.org.
Are your employees happy with the benefits you're offering them? Do you want to hang on to the best employees in 2021? Now's the time to review what you've been doing and see if there's something better. There is. I'm Jim Lorenz. I'm the owner and a fellow AM 560 listener, designing the best benefit packages for companies for over 30 years. Let's talk benefits. Of course, there isn't a single solution to this complex situation, and 60 seconds isn't enough time to tell you all of your options. Clear Insight has a streamlined approach to identify opportunities within your current plan, and we make it easy to implement the options you choose. Let me do the heavy lifting for you. You've got enough to deal with right now. If your employees are important to your business and you want to keep them and save money, Clear Insight Benefits is here to help. Let's set up a go-to meeting or a call at clearinsightbenefits.com. There's not much time left to prepare yourself for a successful 2021. Visit clearinsightbenefits.com.
AM 560, The Answer.
Steve Cortez Show. Sean Thompson back with Steve Cortez. I just like doing it. Hi, Steve. How are you?
I'm great. By the way, I like the Thriller bump music. Fantastic.
Yeah, that might have been one of your old ones because mine is a lot groovier than that. But anyway, the Second Amendment, the assault on our civil liberties is really, it's mind-blowing. And if Biden wins, I want you to help me start a secession movement from Naples, Florida. I don't care what happens to the rest of the country. I don't want to be a part of it anymore. Because the reality is what we're going to see, God forbid, 1,000 times if the Marxists get in, is I think they're going to go after that first, among other things, but that first, and they're going to go after it definitely, and they have been, quietly. You know, with all of the new laws and regulations in place, you know about Illinois and the red flag laws. I take my daughter to the doctor. They're asking my daughter, does your dad have guns? Census report, they're asking about guns. They're asking about money. I mean, I can't believe it's America anymore. So when you see Beto O'Rourke, who has said in the past, I'm coming after you, that's something to take very seriously because it wouldn't be that hard now that both the presidency and if they have all three branches of government, or I mean all three, the House, the Senate, and the presidency, that could really happen.
Oh, absolutely. Well, and by the way, speaking of the third branch of the judiciary, we can't count on the courts, not yet.
John Roberts?
Donald Trump's doing amazing work at remaking the federal judiciary. He is. He absolutely needs four more years to complete it because right now, particularly as you mentioned, John Roberts, when it comes to the Supreme Court, I mean, if you want to talk about a fake conservative or a fake constitutionalist, he's been a massive disappointment. So we cannot count on the courts to protect our rights, which means we've got to do it through the election process. And it's unlikely. I'm not trying to be pessimistic, but it's unlikely that we're going to overturn the House. And if that's the case, it means we just absolutely have to win the Senate, keep the Senate, and we have to keep the presidency, most importantly. But to your point, listen, I'm not being an alarmist here. I mean, judge these people by what they tell us they're going to do. Joe Biden was asked, are you going to take away so-called assault rifles, which, by the way, includes the most popular rifle in America, at least 10 million, by some estimates, as many as 20 million AR-15s have been sold in this country. He was asked if he's going to take it away. His response was, bingo, yes, I'm taking it away. I mean, and we don't even have to guess at all when it comes to the Fexican Beto O'Rourke and what he has said about gun grabbing. Of course, by the way, I love when they try to say that it's a It's a mandatory buyback. It's like, well, if it's mandatory, first of all, it's not a buyback. It's a confiscation. But secondly, it's not a buyback because I didn't buy the gun from you in the first place, government. Okay? Yeah. I bought the gun from my buddy or from Dick's Sports or wherever the heck I bought it. I didn't buy it from the government. So we've got to take this really seriously. There are 4 million new gun owners in America this year, largely because of the unrest all over this country, including in our own city of Chicago, which, as I don't even have to tell the audience how terrible things have been. A lot of people have been really motivated. It takes a lot to get somebody who's never owned a firearm, to get them off the couch, to deal with the expense of it. In a lot of places like Illinois, the process of it, to get a new weapon. 4 million new Americans have bought firearms this year. If we get those people to the polls, and that's a big if, that's our job at the Trump campaign, but if we do, Sean, we're going to get 95% of their votes, because these are right-minded American citizens who care about their own civil liberties and their own self-protection.
You know, I never forget what we're capable of doing to each other. You know, I reflect a lot on history, the Civil War, the most uncivil of all wars, how we just kind of graze over that. And the reality is, I think we've been in a cold Civil War since the 40s. And the assault on man and his freedom and his property and his rights. And these are the kind of things that could take that cold to hot in a hurry. And I'm trying to avoid it. And the way we avoid it is always to refer back to what should be restraints on government and now has become restraints on us. To me, between that and the problem we have with money and with the uncertainty of the future. And the reality is, these people take it so seriously, they go get their hair done when they're supposed to be negotiating different things to help citizens and different programs. And if this guy gets in, he runs the table. I think it's a calamity economically, civilly, and in every way that affects our lives. I think it could very well end very badly in the next 2 years if the Marxists get in.
Yeah. No, listen, I don't think you're exaggerating. I don't think you're being an alarmist. On the economy side, Joe Biden threatens that there will be $4 trillion in new taxes. That is double anything that Hillary Clinton proposed. And he's lying when he says only the rich will be affected. And this is, by the way, is according to Wharton School of Business at Penn, University of Pennsylvania, not exactly a right-wing institution, okay?
No, yeah.
According to their analysis, 82% of taxpayers will see a tax increase. Now, those at the top will get the biggest tax increases, but 82% of American taxpayers are going to see a tax increase. We have, thankfully, a burgeoning recovery going on in this country right now. I really believe it's actually a renaissance right now, but it's young and it's fragile, and it can absolutely be crushed by that kind of a punitive, confiscatory tax scheme. That is what Joe Biden threatens us. So you're right. Not only is he going to assault our rights, but he's also going to immediately assault our prosperity. Why? Because what do the Democrats really want long term? They want dependency. They really do want dependency. They want those in power who, again, live by their set of rules, Nancy Pelosi et al., and then they want a massive dependent class that keeps them in power. That is their vision of the future. It's a dark and dismal vision of the future rather than our vision, which is all about empowerment and growth and freedom. And look, I want to let everyone out there know, as stark as this choice is, unfortunately for a lot of Americans, because there's a lot of anxiety right now out there, which is understandable, right? A lot of sickness, a lot of unemployment. But as stark as this choice is, you might think, well, gosh, this is a layup. Team Trump has to win. No, we may not win, okay? We may not. So I want to motivate everybody out there. You've got to make sure you're registered, and you've got to make sure you vote, and you've got to make sure that all of your friends and neighbors who think the way we do, who respect the Constitution, who love our way of life in this country, that they are registered and that they get out to vote. And I'm encouraging people, be a little bit of a pest, okay?
Yeah.
Get people to vote early, legally vote early, which, of course, we can do in Illinois. And by the way, too, in Illinois, I have no illusions. Trump can't win the state of Illinois. But you know what? There's some congressmen who can, and we can send some red congressmen to flip some
That's business. Right. Genie Ives. But here's the thing.
Yep.
I just want to know, just between me and you, he asking about me at all? He wanted my opinion on anything? I mean, it's not that
he
funny.
He meaning Trump?
Yeah. Is he ask anything? You know, I mean, I'm assuming he listens to the show. He's using a lot of my lines.
He didn't ask yet, but I'm sure he's going to. By the way, I'm a little mad at the boss right now because the boss, meaning Trump, because I really wanted to go to Latrobe, Pennsylvania, where he's – I think he's just landing now. And that's kind of my second hometown. Wife's family's from there. Spent a lot of time there. And it just would have been cool for me to, you know, show up with the President of the United States on Air Force One.
Yeah.
I mean, I'd be kind of, you know, strutting, right?
All right. Well, you got to work on this.
They wanted me on Laura Ingraham tonight. They're like, that's more important, right. Which it is.
Well, don't forget
but I'm not very...
Don't forget the guys you left back home, huh, when you make it at a big time. How about a little something for the guy holding the fourth down? Listen, you've been... I could talk to you for an hour. I really want to do the economy next week. Promise me.
Yeah. Yes, 100%.
All right, good luck. You're doing a good job. You make us all proud. Thank you so much, Steve Cortez. We'll be back with your calls after this.
In the final 100 days before the election, President Trump knew it was time to call in the closer to seal a victory. And the man he called was AM 560's Steve Cortez.
There is nobody that loves this country more than Steve Cortez. Steve.
Steve will return to the air after the election, right here on AM 560, The Answer.
The following is a paid political announcement.
Here's the president of the Illinois Chamber of Commerce, Todd Meisch, talking about the proposed income tax hike amendment on the November state ballot.
Springfield politicians already raised income taxes twice in the last decade. This tax hike amendment would let them increase taxes by billions more whenever they want, and a blank check to spend the money however they want, with no limits and no accountability. It would trigger a huge tax increase on thousands of small business owners and give Illinois the nation's second highest tax rate on large employers. The result would be more closed businesses, more lost jobs, and even more people leaving Illinois. The tax hike amendment is a bad idea at the worst possible time. Please stand with Illinois employers and vote no.
Learn more by visiting notaxhikeamendment.com. Paid for by the Coalition to Stop the Proposed Tax Hike Amendment.
Relief factor, pain relief that's natural, pain relief that works, and pain relief that attacks the source of the pain. That's the experience of tens of thousands of Americans who are taking Relief Factor right now. See their incredible video endorsements at relieffactor.com and then order your three-week quick starter pack for just $19.95. That's less than a dollar a day. Find out if it can work for you like it works for me by ordering your three-week quick starter pack today. Relieffactor.com, relieffactor.com. Be the next success story.
Commission on Police Violence. Good afternoon. It's 84 degrees in Chicago at 5:30. On AM 560, The Answer, I'm Tom Beck. Joe Biden this afternoon said if he's elected, he'll create a White House Police Violence Commission. While visiting Kenosha this afternoon, Biden said he understands frustration in communities of color about police brutality. Biden spoke by phone with Jacob Blake, the Kenosha man who was left paralyzed after being shot by a police officer. His shooting led to violent protests in Kenosha. Democratic leaders of cities where there have been violent protests are furious with President Trump for threatening to cut federal funding to those cities. And Chicago Mayor Lightfoot said if the president wants law and order, he should start with the White House. Vice President Pence today said police departments won't be defunded while President Trump is in office. And he said law and order would be brought back to American cities. On AM 560, The Answer, I'm Tom Beck.
It's open enrollment season, and MediShare is a Christian healthcare sharing ministry that saves most families about $500 a month. Google MediShare and see if it is a fit for you.
There are a lot of different opinions about what school should look like this fall. But when it comes down to it, you need to do what's best for your child, physically and spiritually. You might not know it, but private Christian schools offer smaller class sizes and less crowding, which means they can do in-person, in-classroom teaching safely and effectively. And of course, the teachers are free to share their faith and wisdom instead of fear and uncertainty. It's the kind of environment you want your child to be in this school year. At halfpriceschools.com, you'll find schools from all across Chicagoland that are opening for in-classroom learning this fall. And the best part is that you'll be able to purchase a tuition voucher at half the regular price. All you need to do is go to halfpriceschools.com, find a school near you, purchase a tuition voucher, and prepare to send your child off to school and into the classroom. It's that easy. But don't wait. These vouchers are limited. Go to halfpriceschools.com now.
If you're not listening to Dan and Amy 24/7, then you're missing daily replays of Chicago's Morning Answer. You're also missing The Dan Proft Show, 3 hours of new content each weekday from Dan Proft. You're missing some of the best moments from Dan and Amy from the past. It's all available at danandamy247.com or on the AM560 mobile app when you tap on Choose Stream in the bottom left-hand corner. It's Dan and Amy 24/7.
We all have health goals. But let's face it,
You are living in some fantasy world if you think you are suddenly about to start eating better. In fact, have you thought of this? How many different servings of fruit have you eaten today? How many servings of vegetables? And sorry, Dad, French fries and ketchup don't count. The experts recommend eating over 10 servings of fruits and vegetables each day. That's where Balance of Nature comes in. With 3 fruit and 3 veggie capsules, Balance of Nature gives you all your daily recommended servings and contains 31 different fruits and vegetables. Right now, Balance of Nature is offering free shipping and 35% off any new preferred order of fruits and veggies. Change your life now by calling 800-246-8751. That's 800-246-8751. Or by going to balanceofnature.com and make sure to receive this special radio offer by using discount code Chicago.
Stuck in traffic? We've got the answer. From the AM 560 Traffic Center.
On Chicago's south side, eastbound 79th Street is closed between Anthony Avenue and the Chicago Skyway due to a shooting investigation. Coming in on I-57, it's jammed solid from 167th Street on up to Sibley Boulevard, where that exit ramp is blocked with heavy police activity. Now I-80 up to the Ryan Merge, 27 minutes. North on the Tri-State, the exit to eastbound 159th Street's blocked with an injury accident. South on the Tri-State, just past Willow Road, a crash in the left lane. Kennedy outbound 21 to the split, Express Xavier 542 to the airport. Inbound from O'Hare at 46. Eisenhower in either direction, 55 minutes between 390 and the circle. Stevenson outbound a 45-minute ride from Lakeshore Drive to 355. That's traffic. I'm Mary DeBadges. On AM 560, The Answer.
Now, your official weather forecast.
Clear skies expected overnight. We'll see an overnight low of 58. Mostly sunny and pleasant Friday. We'll reach a high Friday of 79. It'll be warm Saturday with sunshine and patchy clouds. Breezy in the afternoon. Saturday, we'll see a high of 84. I'm Drew Shannon on AM 560, The Answer.
Get the latest weather, traffic, and news updates online at 560theanswer.com. Time now for the AM 560 Opinion Express poll question.
Would you be okay with your school district enforcing a virtual classroom no PJs dress code for students during e-learning sessions?
Vote online at 560theanswer.com.
This hourly segment is brought to you by the NJ Diet Show. Tune in Sunday afternoons 1 to 2 for the NJ Diet Show with Dr. Arthur Turovitz on AM 560, The Answer.
AM 560, The Answer.
It's about time. I'm reflecting on the Steve Cortez conversation. I want to know what you think. 312-642-5600. An aspect of what he said that, you know, we didn't have enough time to expand upon. The idea that you're going to give us $4 trillion in new taxes. I'm so sick of the Marxist rhetoric. I am so sick of their lack of understanding who actually makes the economy go around. It's hard enough when Republicans confuse government spending with prosperity, when the idea of us having debt that's 100 times or 100% of our total worth as a nation, and we just lose focus of it. But the concept that what we need now is more government taxation and more government spending without realizing you're destroying everything. I feel like Charlton Heston when he realizes his ship landed back on Earth and you destroyed everything. Am I the only person that feels like this? The idea that the answer to all of our problems and all that ail us is we need a little bit more of these do-nothing, never-did-anything politicians doing more of that. You know, the reality is I don't think people understand. What do you think politicians do on their daily business? I'm curious. Do you think they do anything other than raise money and sell the power they have? Their entire job, from the time they go to their pretend office till the time they're at the bar with their pretend assistant, who's really their side girlfriend, and we all pretend that it's not Caligula in Washington. It is. And we're going to turn over our entire economy, life, and penalizing people who are good at it to these frauds. What the hell is wrong with you people? Joe Biden for 47 years has done nothing. He did nothing but figure out how to tax you and call it revenue. How to misappropriate those funds so it benefited his friends, his family, and his wallet. You're at a crucial time here in this country. This is it. There is no tomorrow. This is Rocky III, baby. There is no tomorrow. And if this goes the wrong way, listen to me, you're going to be walking around like those people in Venezuela. And that's no joke. That's not hyperbole. I'm not scaring anybody. That's what a country looks like when the government's in charge. How do you like it? Or are you thirsty for more? I'm just disgusted with it, really, that we would even consider turning over the country to career politicians who are literally promising you more control over your existence and more penalty for your fellow man, even if you don't like them. What is the mindset of saying, boy, I hope the government takes that guy's stuff? I just can't get into that mindset, and nor do I ever want to. But what you see is the envy in the Democrat Party, the control, the enjoyment of the power, but most importantly, the covetous nature of a Democrat. It is a dirty word to me. It really is. Mike, how are you, Mike, in the 18-wheeler?
Hey, how you doing?
Good.
How you doing?
I'm aggravated, but how are you?
Oh, yeah. Well, I've been aggravated for years.
Go ahead.
My question is, why does everybody just assume that 100 million people who own 300 million guns is just going to roll over and say, sure, here are my guns, take them?
Do you know why, I think? You remember what happened with the gold? You know, this happened in our country before, only it was gold instead of guns. And what they do is they entice you into it. Now, Mike, what they're going to do, it's not going to be kick in your door and take your gun. They're going to make it advantageous for you to turn in your gun because you're going to be under a financial squeeze like you've never lived through. The reality of $4 trillion in new taxes, the reality of more government control over our economy means a drastic amount of people are going to be poor. I mean, you look at these areas where government's in control and you show me where the rich people are who aren't affiliated with the government. You know, I mean, so when you get desperate, Mike, if they come to you and they say, hey, we'll give you $10,000 a gun and you got to feed your kids, you're a truck driver. I see it on the screen. You're a hardworking guy. Would you turn in your four guns for $40,000 to feed your kids? The answer is yeah. I mean, they don't have to force it. They're creative in how they get it from you.
Well, you answered for me incorrectly.
All right.
I would not turn them in.
All right. I didn't say if you would. I just said, would you be tempted to if you're broke, if you have no money?
No.
All right.
I would not.
All right. Well, listen, and you know, good for you. I think that's great. But you do understand how that could appeal to people with kids and people who have nothing. That, you know what I mean? You could understand how it would appeal. And then the other thing is,
yeah,
what do they do? How did they start a civil war before? I mean, you know, slow at first and then real fast at the end. I mean, you know, if what you're saying is you think there'll be a civil war and everybody with a gun will automatically be on the side we're on of the citizen and freedom, it doesn't work like that. You see in these major cities, these are Americans. It's sad. They're sad Americans and they're wrong. But these Antifa people, these are Americans. You know, so then you've got chaos in the streets. I mean, I get the innuendo, but the reality is we're going to have to, I mean, I hope we never do, but we could have to live through these kind of choices. I want to avoid them all. And the way you do it is by not electing Biden. But, you know, you have
right.
to admit, Mike, they're telling you right now. This is serious. That's why Steve said, you know, it's not hyperbole. They're telling you we're coming after them. So ultimately, we're going to have the answers to these questions.
And I understand that, but what happens if we get Trump reelected and 4 years from now, they're still there?
Yeah.
The left is still going to be there. What do we do then?
Right, which is why.
You know, do we just keep going on and on praying that the right gets back in power so that our country can go forward?
It's the sad game.
I think it's past the point of no return, actually, no matter which way the election goes. Mm-hmm. It's going to be, if the left gets in, do you think that these anarchists are going to stop what they're doing? No, because the left isn't going to give them enough of what they want. And if the right gets in, still, do you think they're going to stop? No.
Yeah. Well,
I think we're past the point of no return.
Here's the, I think, first of all, Mike, I'm not disagreeing with you. Thank you, by the way, for the call. I really appreciate it. I'm not disagreeing with you. But what I think happens if the right gets in is that what should happen is that there will be penalties for breaking the law. And you have to understand this kind of thing you're seeing in these Democrat mafia run states and cities. They're not happening in the Republican run ones. Why? Because there is penalty there. You know, crime goes where it's welcome. It's like money. It'll go where it's welcome. So the reality is there was an expose on the news last night. I watched it. I couldn't believe it. They were upset that they had roadblocks in Kenosha enforcing the curfew as the city was under attack. They had an innuendo that the police were racist because they were stopping cars with people who were going up there to support the rioters. See, this is why they convolute it between protest and riot. This is why they keep calling it a protest. This is why, win, lose, or draw, it is established we do not have a media in this country. We have a Marxist PR group. That's all they are. They're a Marxist public relation group, and they're coming up with the words to spin it. They're coming up with the attacks on the idea that there will be consequences for lawbreakers. So what you have here is a propaganda machine that's protecting the state, because one thing that's absolutely unarguable, our press is for a very big, very strong, very totalitarian government. They like it that way. That's what our press is. So until we understand that we need to inform our kids and we need to talk to our representatives, it is about time that, and it's only going to come from the Republican side, that we make very clear the restraints, the concepts, the little creative vehicles you want to pretend with our lives, that stops, and that the restraint is on you. It's very clear that we need to reestablish that. My question to you is, can we reestablish it? I want your opinion. 312-642-5600. It's crucially right now is the time.
From AM 560 to the campaign trail, Steve Cortez is on special assignment with the Trump campaign. But don't worry, he'll be back after the election right here on AM 560. The Answer.
We're all aware of national dealers that sell gold and silver. But national dealers? It sounds so impersonal and far away. Guess what? Fox Valley Coins in Naperville is a national dealer, and they're right here in our backyard. With Fox Valley Coins close by, you won't have to relinquish your personal information and money through the mail and hope that you receive what you ordered in the next days, weeks, or months. Most of the time at Fox Valley Coins, you just walk in the store, pick out what you want, pay for it, and walk out the door. It can be that easy. And if you're interested in selling your rare collector coins or currency, Fox Valley Coins specialize in the rare ones. Buying and selling individual coins and currency, as well as all gold, silver, platinum, palladium, and rhodium, in coin, bar, and scrap form. They'll even make house calls when appropriate. Fox Valley Coins is one light north of I-88 on Route 59 in Naperville. They're closed on Sundays and have been dealing with integrity since 1981. Check out foxvalleycoins.com. That's foxvalleycoins.com.
Most of us have been spending a lot more time at home recently. Perhaps you've noticed it's time to upgrade your sheets and pillows. Now's the time to join the millions of Americans who have changed the quality of their sleep with MyPillow. And even as MyPillow changes their production to provide masks for hospitals, they still want to help you get the best sleep of your life. Right now, buy one, get one free pricing on Supima MyPillows, Giza Dream Sheets, towels, roll and go anywhere pillows, duvet covers, Giza pillowcases, bolster pillows, and neck pillows. Just go to the Radio Listener Specials page at MyPillow.com and use the promo code Steve or call 800-489-0201. If you order Mike Lindell's book, your entire MyPillow order will ship for free, and you'll receive a $25 gift card for your next purchase. Don't miss this incredible opportunity to buy one, get one free on pillows, sheets, duvets, and more from MyPillow. Call 800-489-0201 or go to the Radio Listener Specials page at MyPillow.com. Promo code Steve.
This is Jerry Boyer of Town Hall Finance for townhall.com. These are tense and unsettling times for our nation, with ongoing protests in many of our major cities and a sense of unease about how the next incident may further inflame things. So, how should we respond to protesters who are either violent or aggressive to the point of interfering with normal life? Certainly not by returning violence for violence, not by aggressive counter-demonstrations, and not by any sort of vigilante activity. We can't fight evil with evil. Lasting social change always comes from peaceful appeals to the broad middle class in America. So when they riot, let's focus on the wise response. Instead of filling the streets with angry counter-protests, let's fill the ballot box with our protest vote. When they riot, we register. When they vent, we vote. And when they slap us on the right cheek, let's cast the right vote. Head to our polling station or home to our absentee ballots, and we vote for law and order. I'm Jerry Boyer.
AM 560, The Answer.
All right, I went too long on my dissertation, so we've got calls. I want to get everybody in. Nobody get mad. You're going to be in line. You got about 35 seconds. Dave and Niles.
The previous caller was wrong. This election is going to make a huge difference. It's a pushback. Mm-hmm. And the fight against communism goes on every day in every country. It's not something you win an election and it's all over. And we don't just roll over and say, okay, it's an eventuality, so we might as well just eat it now. Oh, no. We have to fight. We've got to stand up for our country. It was given to us, and we want to give it to our children.
I agree, Dave. But you know where I think he was right? In the idea that we can count on just electing Republicans to save it. Because, you know, if you do realize, we were talking about John Roberts on the Supreme Court. I mean, this guy, he's a coin toss is an understatement. He is a statist. He likes to side with government. He doesn't side with people and freedom. So that's something we need to be, you know, wary
of. Well, we have people like you that keep pulling the drape back. Who's behind the curtain?
Yeah,
and
gangsters.
And that's come through the good press.
Thank you, Dave. I appreciate that. Never thought I'd be called press, but I'll take it. Jeff Addison, how are you, Jeff?
Great. Love the show.
Thank you.
John Adams said, "The Constitution was written for a moral and religious people. It is wholly inadequate for the governance of anyone else." So stick a fork in it. We're never going to recover from this.
I got to say something, Jeff. I'm not religious. I got to confess to you. I don't want to pretend to be something I'm not. I don't know if you have to be religious to believe in the rule of law. I agree with the overarching point. I'm just not religious. I got time for Matt? Yeah? All right, Matt, we're under the gun. We got about 40 seconds, kid.
Sean, I just want to say, man, I'm right behind you. Uncle Joe is moving too kind of slow, and I'm ready for it going on with Mr. Donald Trump, President of the United States. I think the media is going to have to go into the trash can and start over, man.
Yeah, I'll tell you what. I think they did Donald Trump and the Republicans a huge favor. I don't think they understood how this guy looks. Did you see him getting off the plane today? It was a big achievement that he made it down the stairs. But when he's walking, he's leaning forward. It's. I would pity him if I wasn't so aware of how dangerous he is to the country. And I appreciate the call, Matt. Thank you so much. We will be back. We have Matt Welch, editor at large. Why can't he be at small? Editor at large at Reason. He's also a co-host. He's written a book. How can we save it? Because the reality is we still can't. And it's through the way we always built it. Freedom, liberty, and me and you when we get back.
AM 560's Steve Cortez is on special assignment working on President Trump's re-election campaign. He'll be back after the election in November right here on AM 560, The Answer. Ever wish you could hear Chicago's Morning Answer with Dan Proft and Amy Jacobson at some time other than in the morning? Well, now you can. With Dan and Amy 24-7, go to danandamy247.com or launch the AM 560 mobile app and click on Choose Stream in the bottom left-hand corner. Hey, now you can hear replays of Chicago's Morning Answer, the best of Dan and Amy, and the Dan Proft Show all day, every day on Dan and Amy 24-7.
Do you know which American president made Labor Day a federal holiday? The answer after this. Families are spending more time together in the backyard on their outdoor patios and decks. So now's a great time to make your landscape everything you want it to be. AM Woodland Outdoor Design, along with Lots Custom Carpentry, are ready to make your outdoor adventures at home the best they can be.
From patios to pergolas to outdoor kitchens and fire pits, even the practical stuff like complete drainage work to keep the rain out of your home. For all the projects you've been thinking about or putting off, they'd love to meet with you to discuss ideas. Count on the AM Woodland and Lots Custom Carpentry teams to be there for you, to beautify and make your home everything you've always wanted it to be. Local, family-owned businesses are so important for our communities, and your support is truly appreciated.
AM Woodland Outdoor Design and Lots Custom Carpentry, proudly serving Lake, McHenry, Northern Cook, and Kenosha counties. Visit amwoodland.com or call 847-224-2167.
Grover Cleveland was not known as a friend of labor, but on June 28, 1894, he signed legislation designating the first Monday in September as a federal holiday. As we celebrate Labor Day this year, we're grateful for the hard work of all Americans in our labor force. From AM Woodland Outdoor Design and AM 560, The Answer.
There are a lot of tough questions when thinking about caring for aging parents or loved ones. Most importantly, can they stay safe at home? With Home Care Angels Home Services, they can. Home Care Angels has been caring for seniors in their homes with compassionate and holistic non-medical care for the past 15 years. The Home Care Angel caregivers are certified in dementia care, COVID-19, and in-home care. You'll get highly qualified caregivers carefully selected for your loved ones to help with activities of daily living, meal prep, light housekeeping, or 24/7 live-in care. Due to COVID-19, they've taken extra precautions and implemented protocols consistent with CDC guidelines to ensure the quality and safety of all their clients. Home Care Angels is in Des Plaines, Illinois, and services all of Chicagoland and the suburbs. To request a free in-home assessment, call 847-824-5221. That's 847-824-5221. Home Care Angels is a proud member of the Home Care Association of America.
We know that sometimes it might be difficult to hear AM 560, like when you drive under that bridge, or you get too close to power lines, or when you're surrounded by gigantic concrete and steel buildings, which is why we've made it easy to listen to us whenever you want, wherever you might be. We're always streaming at 560theanswer.com and on the AM 560 mobile app. You can also get us on your Alexa-powered smart speaker, and we're on TuneIn, iHeart, and Radio.com. You can listen wherever and whenever to AM 560, The Answer.
The following is a paid political announcement.
Hi, I'm Dr. Willie Wilson. In my life, I've gone from cotton field to corporate boardroom. I've seen great success and walked many roads. I know how it feels not to have. I'm asking you to vote for me for U.S. Senate for the state of Illinois. I can do the work that few others may understand. A vote for me is a step in the right direction for our state and our country.
Paid for by Willie Wilson for Senate 2020.
You are in the middle of nowhere. No one knows where you are. And it's going to stay that way.
On September 18th, don't miss Infidel, the new heart-pounding political thriller inspired by true events. Infidel tells the story of one man's incredible journey of faith and survival after being kidnapped in the Middle East, and his wife's courage to never give up on him. When his country abandoned him, his freedom became her mission. Starring Jim Caviezel. See Infidel only in theaters September 18th.
It's news, opinion, insight. It's AM 560, The Answer. WIND, Chicago.
We've got two things we've got to accomplish. We've got to win in November 3rd. We've got to fix it November 4th. That's the main thing. We're going to talk about that when we get back after Fox News.
The job. I'm Lisa Lacerra, Fox News. The mayor of Rochester, New York, has suspended a group of police officers involved in the death by suffocation of a black man. Daniel Prude died March 30th after his family took him off life support. 7 days after officers who encountered him running naked through the streets put a hood on him to stop him from spitting, then held him down until he stopped breathing.
Mr. Daniel Prude was failed by our police department, our mental health care system, our society, and he was failed by me.
Rochester Mayor Lovely Warren. Body camera footage of the incident was released yesterday by Prude's family that they obtained through a public records request. Democratic presidential nominee Joe Biden traveled to Kenosha, Wisconsin today, where he met with the family of Jacob Blake, the black man shot and severely wounded during an encounter with police.
What I came away with was the overwhelming sense of resilience and optimism that they have about the kind of response they're getting.
Biden said he also spoke with Jacob Blake and that he talked about how nothing was going to defeat him and whether or not he walked again. He was not going to give up. President Trump was in Kenosha Tuesday but did not meet with Blake's family. This hour, the president is in Latrobe, Pennsylvania for a campaign-style event. Democrats on the House Oversight Committee seeking an investigation of what they call repeated violations of the federal Hatch Act by members of the Trump administration during the Republican National Convention. The law is intended to limit political activity by federal employees in their official capacity, although it does not apply to the president and vice president. White House Chief of Staff Mark Meadows has dismissed the concerns, saying nobody outside the Beltway really cares. America is listening to Fox News.
With all the noise and political spin of the news cycle, it's easy for the things that really matter to get lost. Sources with knowledge cuts through all the clutter to bring you biting commentary on the week's events. This Sunday at 3 p.m., your hosts Eric Cohn and Joe Kaiser bring you insight on politics and policy, as well as culture, sports, food, and everything else you need, so you can understand what's happened this week. It's Sources with Knowledge this Sunday at 3 p.m. right here on AM 560, The Answer.
Balance of Nature, changing the world one life at a time.
I just had a baby, and I'm tired, but I could tell you this, without Balance of Nature, there's no way I would have the energy I have right now. I've done so many different multivitamins and different things, and I have to definitely say Balance of Nature is the thing that's really, really helping me right now. I've been listening to this, these commercials and these testimonials, and I'm like, okay, whatever. But this is a product that I actually could say, holy cow, I see results.
Get a wide variety of all your daily recommended servings of whole fruits and vegetables without having to leave your home. Right now, Balance of Nature is offering free shipping and 35% off on any new preferred order. Call 800-246-8751. That's 800-246-8751. Or by going to balanceofnature.com. Again, that's balanceofnature.com. And make sure to receive this special radio offer by using discount code Chicago.
So who is your wireless provider? AT&T, Verizon, T-Mobile? The average person is saving $400 a year by switching to Pure Talk USA. Pure Talk is on the same network, same towers, just 50% off in terms of price. Right now, get unlimited talk, text, and 2 gigs of data for just $20 a month. Switch to Pure Talk today. Now, from your cell phone, dial #250 and say Pure Radio. That's #250, Pure Radio, Pure Talk USA, simply smarter wireless.
Progressive Motorcycle presents Road Wisdom from the Motor.
Half man, half motorcycle.
Ride confidently in the direction of your dreams. Unless it's a bad dream. Then turn around.
Go the other way.
Progressive Motorcycle also presents basic policy starting at $75 a year. Progressive Motorcycle, for those who were born to ride. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Annual premium for basic liability policy is not available in all states.
Mattress Firm's Labor Day sale is going on now. Save up to $500 when you get a king bed for a queen price or a queen for a twin. Plus, get a free adjustable base when you spend $699 or more. Or save 50% on top-rated brands like Beautyrest, Serta, and Sealy. Shop now.
How can you get from here to there? We've got the answer from the AM 560 Traffic Center.
On the south side, eastbound 79th Street is closed between Anthony Avenue and the Chicago Skyway. This is due to a shooting investigation. Headed northbound on the tri-state at 127th Street, there's a crash blocking two left lanes. Kennedy outbound 17 to the split, ditto in the express, 38 to the airport. Back inbound from the airport 49, 34 of that off the junction. Eisenhower either way busy, 54 minutes between 390 and the circle. Now, do keep in mind that on the inbound Eisenhower, the exit to the outbound Kennedy has reopened a week in advance. Some good news there. Stevenson outbound, sluggish to Cicero, Lakeshore Drive. Drive on out to 355 and 41. North on I-57, crawling 167th on up to Sibley. That exit ramp blocked with police activity. That's traffic. I'm Mary DeBatches on AM 560, The Answer.
Now, your official weather forecast.
Overnight, clear skies, the overnight low 58.
Friday, mostly sunny and pleasant. Friday's high, 79. Saturday will be warm with sunshine and patchy clouds. It'll be breezy in the afternoon, the high, 84. I'm Drew Shannon on AM 560, The Answer.
Get the latest weather, traffic, and news updates online at 560theanswer.com.
This hourly segment is brought to you by the Alpha Wealth Group, bringing the trilogy of estate, tax, and investment planning together. Visit alphawealthgroup.com for a free report.
Steve Cortez is on special assignment with the Trump re-election campaign. While he's away, filling in for Steve is Sean Thompson.
We are back. I always love the segments when we get to talk to people from think tanks, people who have a different perspective, and people who understand. We definitely have to fend off the Marxists on November 3rd, but we have to fix things on November 4th. And I'm happy to bring on Matt Welch, editor-at-large at Reason, co-host of We the Fifth, and author of The Declaration of Independence, How Libertarian Politics Can Fix What's Wrong with America. Matt, thank you so much for joining me. How are you?
Thanks so much for having me. It's great to be back.
I'm interested in this because I really do, Matt. I really think it's an urgent situation, all right? When we agree on bipartisan takeover of our freedoms and liberties and the money supply, I get nervous, Matt. I get nervous. I don't like it. So in your last roundtable, you stated that the next couple of months are going to get very dark. Now, does it have to get very dark? Come on, Matt. I mean, I got a lot going on. I got three businesses. We're bleeding like a sieve here. I mean, how dark are we going to get?
Well, I mean, your communications with anybody that you know professionally, probably personally. No, it's whenever you have the prime directive being from one side, you know, you're stemming the tide against the Marxist takeover. This will be the last America that we see ever again. And then on the other side, this is the last step before fascism. People are not in the mood of having some kind of nuanced chat. It's just going to be Flight 93 elections all the way down. And meanwhile, you know, there's people shooting each other on the streets. It's not at the same scale as in 1968 or even 1972, when you've forgotten a lot of bad memories, thankfully and usefully, in our country's recent history. But it's going to be bad. And let's be honest about what's happening to all of us in our lives. This pandemic and the reactions to it and the impositions that it's put on our lives and the uncertainty about the 57 million kids who are kind of not going back to school this fall, everyone's a little stressed out right now. And so national politics against that backdrop, where everyone thinks that they're fighting totalitarianism one way or the other, it's just going to be an ugly 2 months for sure.
Matt, I agree with you, and things are a lot spicier than anybody's ever really witnessed that's alive during this time that isn't 90 years old. And, you know, I have to say, I do believe in my heart of hearts when I read the 110-page Marxist Manifesto and the Green New Deal and the new taxes, I lose my mind. And when I do reflect back on what happened, you know, you have to understand, I'm calling you, or we're talking from the mafia hub of America, all right? We don't have Democrats and Republicans. We have a Democrat mafia and all those guys trying to get in there. So it's a little different for me because our governor took power I never thought he was capable of taking. And what we've seen in this COVID, it's, you know, whether you look at these very totalitarian, draconian states that just take your life, I don't want that. I have the right to disagree up until March. How do I get it back?
Yeah, well, good luck with that. sadly, no, listen, I'm talking to you from New York, where we have, you know, the governor and the mayor, who thankfully at least hate each other, so there's some creative friction there. But it's a one-party state as well. But Bill de Blasio is the most hated mayor in the country. He won re-election by 40 percentage points. There isn't political competition. And in our increasingly polarized and geographically polarized country, you're going to have that. You're going to have states, you're going to have cities that are overwhelmingly red or overwhelmingly blue. Neither of those, in my view, are a good recipe for good governance. They're a recipe for corruption and bad governance all the way down. The one silver lining, and it's only that, that I would say as one is imagining, let's say, a possible Biden victory, is not that Biden is worth a good gravy from my point of view, but he didn't run on that stuff. In that field, everybody else was running, you know, to either be more woke than he was and try to attack him there, including Kamala Harris back then, or to be way more socialist than he is. And he is the one who won. And I think it's always important to keep in mind how and why people won their primary contests, including Donald Trump back in 2016. He won using he was different than the rest of the field on a few big issues, some of which I disagree with him vociferously on, a couple of which I agree with him on. But so it's important to see how and why someone differentiated what they campaigned on and how they won. That has something to do with how they may govern. The case against even what I just said is that, hey, look, Biden is the weakened at Bernie's candidate. And inside of, you know, the old guy at the beach in the chair, there's just going to be a lot of AOC. There's going to be a lot of Green New Deal, even though he was campaigning comparatively against that. Once he gets into office, and then the world will look more like Chicago or Brooklyn. I certainly hope not, unless they're just talking about pizza.
But let's talk about this, though, man. And I'm going to talk to I only do interviews like you were in my cigar store and we're arguing. So you'll have to forgive me at the end of it. So here's my thing. The Democrat primary is never honest. The candidate is picked well ahead, and it's a Potemkin pretend system, where they're handpicking these people long before the pretend contest they show us, which is why Hillary got in. She didn't win that. Which is why Biden got in. He didn't win that. I mean, the reality is he's weak and feeble, and everyone knows it. He didn't have the support of the voters. If it wasn't for that scoundrel gangster in North Carolina, who everybody votes the way he tells them to do, his name escapes me at the moment, it's a Chicago version, only in North Carolina, where the politician tells you how to vote if you want your job, if you want your cousin's job, and yada, yada, yada. And he wins. Now he's there. Now he accepts the Biden fiscal plan, the 110-page declaration on a war on capitalism. I mean, if you read that thing, have you looked at it? The Biden-Sanders plan?
God, no, I have enough pornography in my life.
I challenge you to get through the first 35 pages without, I have a heavy bag in my garage, without either hitting the heavy bag or throwing your clicker. I'm old. I call the remote a clicker. But that's the way it goes. You can't get through 35 pages of it, brother. And now the declaration of $4.5 trillion in new taxes. The absolute admission of, if you don't think Trump spent enough, I'm going to spend more, which I don't like Trump spending. So my thing is, I'm that apprehensive about him making not just a soft left, but a hard left.
Here's where I agree and disagree with you. Okay. I disagree with you in that voters didn't pick him. I think that they did. I think that all polling at all times in this campaign, with exception or the primary campaign, with the exception of a week or two here and there, Biden has been out ahead. And no one really could assert themselves beyond, you know, a momentary Bernie or Elizabeth Warren flourish. And the comparative center was always, whoever that was in there at the time, you know, Biden, Buttigieg, Bloomberg, was always bigger than the kind of Democratic Socialist side as a bloc, always. And I think that reflected where voters were at, not necessarily with their policies, but about what they thought could sell, because they're so agitated about beating Donald Trump. And I think it's significant that the black vote, which tends to be more conservative than white liberals in Brooklyn, white progressives in Brooklyn, I should say, came out overwhelmingly for Joe Biden. Joe Biden, my metaphor for him is that he's a rusty weather vane, and this will provide people comfort and frustration and fear, depending on where you sit. Which is to say, like, he's going to go in the direction that the wind blows. He's just going to kind of creak in that direction, right? Like, he's attuned to it. It's part of his campaign. It's part of his politics. He was sort of a triangulatory Bill Clinton type. He was always, like, super tough on crime. He used to brag about having his name on every single Patriot Act, every crime bill, every, like, immigration bill, like an immigration crackdown type of bill. He loved having his name on that kind of stuff. Well, the wind has changed. So now he's creaking in this direction. And so the hope for those of you, of those of us who are like me and you, especially about economic policy, is that there's a lot of rust in that weather vane, because there's not a lot of hope otherwise. The problem is the wind is blowing so hard. Democrats on economics in the last 10 years have gone so far to the left, not just on economics, but about stuff like school choice. Barack Obama and Arne Duncan, they had their flaws for sure on the issue. However, they did preference some of school choice initiatives from the federal government. That's done. That era of the Democratic Party is done. There is this big kind of AOC and Bernie momentum. That wind is going to be blowing hard. So we're going to be cheering for Joe Biden's rust. There is no sense of quietude about that. That is terrifying on many levels. However, it's important to point out, and I'm glad that you referenced that, you know, Donald Trump spent a lot of money too. The breaks from the Republican side on fiscal just spending everything and not caring about the future, those were removed. They've been removed systematically by Republicans in the Senate, in the House, and by Donald Trump. And so now neither party's talking about this stuff. It's over for us at the moment until something collapses. That is ultimately the thing that I'm most terrified of, is that no matter who wins, we're screwed about that.
Yeah, I couldn't agree with you more. But here's the other thing, Matt, and I mean this, and I don't care. Hey, listen, I'm not running for anything. I'm not looking for any more friends. The reality is, I see this guy as feeble, weak, and clearly out of touch. Now, I could blame it on the fact that for 47 years he never really worked and just spent his days prostituting government and drinking with his pals and trying to pick up chicks afterwards. I mean, that's the real life of what Joe Biden has done for 47 years. But to say that he has all his faculties, I have a thing. He can't get a driver's license or a job in any of the 50 states. The only thing this guy has the possibility of ever doing again is running the country. I don't care if you call me ageist. I don't care what it is. These people are too damn old.
My father is 81, and this month we're moving him out of the house that he's lived in for longer than I've been alive, and I was born when Lyndon Johnson was president. And for those of us who've gone through the process of helping out our parents transition to the next phase, you see and recognize certain tendencies. Joe Biden's a hale 77-year-old, but 77 or whatever, he's 77, 76, I forget. But
he'll be 78 next month in November. He'll be 78 after the election.
That's a number that, you know, back when Reagan was running for the first time, he was, what, 69, something like that? Like,
first
and
time,
people were making jokes about his age. That's old. And he's been running for president since before I went through puberty, I'm pretty sure. This is like his seventh time that he's been thinking about it. And it's a real sign about how lousy our two-party politics have become. At least he's not quite as hated as Hillary Clinton was. And his sense of corruption is a much smaller scale, I think, than the Clinton machine sense of corruption. But it's a sad sign that someone who was a laughably non-presidential forever is now like the default, the last best hope to be someone who's saleable out there. That shows how desperate we are, right? Like people are not running people who they're excited about. They're running people who they think is the best sale that they can have against who they view as Hitler, and there in that direction lies, like, it's going to get worse. The person who's going to replace Trump, or, you know, who's going to run in 2024 or 2028, depending on what it is, or either 2024, is going to be worse than Trump in many ways. The next Democratic person is going to be worse than Biden. We're in a really bad clenched cycle, and I hope that people consider finding ways to themselves escape from it.
Matt, can you stick with me through the break? And I promise I'll actually ask you about an article you wrote rather than this conversation. Thank you so much, Matt, for hanging on. We'll be back. More with Matt when we get back.
In the final 100 days before the election, President Trump knew it was time to call in the closer to seal a victory. And the man he called was AM 560's Steve Cortez.
There is nobody that loves this country more than Steve Cortez. Steve.
Steve will return to the air after the election, right here on AM 560, The Answer.
Napa Know How. at Napa, you can get a 5-quart jug of Mobil 1 Full Synthetic Motor Oil for $26.99. An incredible oil for an unbeatable price from the best car people around. Making this deal the best of the best of the best of the best of the best deals around. That's Mobil 1, only $26.99. Quality parts, helpful people. That's Napa know-how.
Napa know-how!
General States pricing. Sales prices not include applicable state, local taxes, or recycling fees. Offer ends 9/30/20.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
There's no better feeling than grilling out, and there's no better place than Ace to get the best grill for you and your family. We have the hottest grills from top brands like Big Green Egg, Traeger, and Weber. And since our stores are locally owned and we're committed to helping our neighbors, we'll also assemble and deliver your grill for free. Around the block, what you need in stock with people who know their grills. Offer valid for Ace Rewards members through September 7th on grills and accessories $3.99 and up. See participating stores for scheduling or exclusions.
More than 1.3 million people are living with a blood cancer in the United States. Every 3 minutes, someone is diagnosed with leukemia, lymphoma, myeloma, MDS, or another blood cancer, impacting the patient as well as their family and loved ones. The Leukemia Research Foundation, founded in 1946 in Chicago, is dedicated to conquering all blood cancers by funding research into their causes and cures, and enriching the quality of life of those touched by these diseases. September is Blood Cancer Awareness Month. We're asking you to fight with us by spreading awareness and helping to raise money to fund the research that leads to better treatments and ultimately the cures for these diseases. And to help people and families living with a diagnosis now through patient education programs and a needs-based patient assistance program. Visit allbloodcancers.org to connect with the Leukemia Research Foundation on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, LinkedIn, and YouTube. View, participate, and share the information you find throughout September and beyond. And please donate. Together, we can and will conquer all blood cancers.
Napa know-how.
At Napa, you can get a 5-quart jug of Mobil 1 Full Synthetic Motor Oil for $26.99. An incredible oil for an unbeatable price from the best car people around. Making this deal the best of the best of the best of the best of the best deals around. That's Mobil 1, only $26.99. Quality parts, helpful people. That's Napa know-how.
Napa know-how.
General States pricing. Sales prices not include applicable state, local taxes, or recycling fees. Offer ends 9/30/20.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
There's no better feeling than grilling out, and there's no better place than Ace to get the best grill for you and your family. We have the hottest grills from top brands like Big Green Egg, Traeger, and Weber. And since our stores are locally owned and we're committed to helping our neighbors, we'll also assemble and deliver your grill for free. Around the block, what you need in stock with people who know their grills. Offer valid for Ace Rewards members through September 7th on grills and accessories $3.99 and up. See participating stores for scheduling or exclusions.
AM 560, The Answer.
Thank you for sticking with me through the break. It's Matt Welch, editor at Reason. I'm not going to do the at-large stuff. We're familiar now. Matt, I got a question about this article. So I had a little debate yesterday. Here's the thing. I want to preface it. I believe in life, all you have is your principles. That's it. It's okay when you must be maybe forced to slightly compromise. It's never okay to break. Right? So these people who were Tea Party people, these people who were conservatives, these people who have such an animosity towards Trump, that they are under the delusion it's okay to vote for a guy who stands juxtaposed to every principle you've ever espoused. Versus, just don't vote. There's a certain dignity. I used to say I'll never vote against myself. I'm voting against myself when I accept Keynesianism and these things. But however, I'm doing it because to me, I'm defeating an evil I can't tolerate. So I want your kind of opinion on, you don't really have to do either one, and there's a principle-based way to do it.
I should start with the throat clear that everyone's reasons for voting are all pretty much equally terrible. And I say this as someone who loves the I voted sticker, and I'm saying that my reasons for voting, my theories about it, are terrible. It's hard for me to get all judgy about how people do it. There might be some people who were strongly Tea Party and who really cared about trillion-dollar deficits, which, by the way, came back long before coronavirus came around. But like, who are going to vote for Biden knowing that he might make that worse? Well, they might have their reason, and their reason is that they find Trump's behavior to be beyond the pale, full stop, and character matters. That's fine. That's an argument. right? But as long as they're being honest with themselves about it. What I, where I live is when people are voting for Trump because he's a, you know, he's the limited government candidate, or, you know, because he's going to stem the tide against socialism. He might beat someone who might be more socialist. That's an argument. But that Trump himself is interested in limiting government, I'm not going to sit idly by and listen to that argument, because the only way in which he is expressed or shown or demonstrated any interest in that at all is by slowing down the growth of the regulatory state. And that sounds like I'm damning with faint praise. I'm not. He's actually been the biggest deregulatory president since Ronald Reagan.
Yeah.
And spent some effort on that. I've written about this at some length. But be clear, what that has meant in total is that he's slowed down the growth. We still have more regulations. They still have more of an impact, et cetera, et cetera. Meanwhile, in 3 years, he, under his Sharpie, has grown or the size of the federal government has grown under his Sharpie as much, the annual price tag, by more than $900 billion than it did under Barack Obama in eight. Let's be honest about it. Let's be serious about that. You can say, and it is an argument, and it's perhaps the best argument, that it would be worse under Biden. Okay. But it's bad under Trump. It's not just bad, it's real bad. Mm-hmm. He's a guy who competed against his contemporaries in 2015 and 16 and has governed like that ever since, of I am not going to touch entitlements, even though everybody who is at all a serious person who looks at the price tag coming, the bills coming due for Social Security, Medicare, Medicaid, say this is untenable. We got 10 years. The report came out this week. We've got 10 years before people are going to be taking haircuts, mandatory haircuts, because we didn't deal with this problem when times were good. He said, I'm not going to deal with this. I'm laughing at the Paul Ryans of the world, who, don't get me wrong, it's worth laughing at for a lot of reasons. But at least he was talking about that. Trump represented a new type of GOP politics, which was, not going to touch that. I'm going to be anti-trade, and I'm going to be really restrictionist on immigration. Those were kind of new twists in Republican politics, and some of those twists, from my point of view, are really quite bad. So you can, yes, you can get on the Tea Party people for saying that, like, Biden's going to be great on that, because he's going to be really bad too, and in some measures worse. But Trump has also been bad and also violated many principles that the 2009 era Tea Party held dear.
So I'm like you, I'm a capitalist. And all of those things you mentioned are violations of capitalism. But I want to say just two things. I'm voting for Trump. No questions asked. And I'm going to tell you why. The regulation destruction. And I say this to you, not as a religious. I'm not hiding behind any religion. All right? I'm not. Our job as men is to protect children. I mean this. It is an atrocity to me that the only murder we allow in this country that's legal is when somebody slaughters their kid. A woman slaughters her kid. I think it's outrageous. It is such an infant argument. It is such an anti-intellectual. And just in my bones, that's the one innocent thing in this world. That's the only thing that has the right to live. You want to kill somebody? I got no problem with killing bad people. Let's kill the convicts and pardon the baby. That's my thing. So on those two issues, they're bigger than the capitalism to me. And I'm a capitalist. I own a site called Capitalist Union. And so, to me, those are the two reasons. And this other party that wants to take my money, knowing how I feel, and make me pay for the whacking and the hit job on a baby, I got a big issue with a kid. I just do. I know it's crazy, but I'm not religious. You know, I just want to point that to you.
No, that's actually again. Every reason is kind of equally bad, but real reasons that are held to on principle and carried through over time and over elections, that's where my respect lies, right? And it might not be anything that I necessarily personally agree with or disagree with, but like holding that stuff steady through the years, I think is great. The other thing I would add to the conversation that people forget, because we relentlessly nationalize everything. I'm a New York City public school parent, and they can't figure out how to open up the schools because they're still mad at Donald Trump, even though he doesn't run the schools. It is infuriating. But part of that is that despite, the 2016 example, we somehow forget that there's this thing called the Electoral College.
Yes.
And that there are states where, for instance, the state that I'm standing in has voted by at least 15 percentage points for the Democratic nominee in every election since the end of the Cold War. New York is not going to vote for Trump. It's not going to happen, right? So I know a lot of people who are like, well, you know, we have to vote for him. We have to vote for Biden, even though we hate him for whatever reason that might be, or we fear him because Trump might win. People don't think that strategically. Illinois is the same place. California, a lot of red states haven't voted for a Democrat since Lyndon Johnson in 1964. And in many cases, it's been like 20 percentage points for the last five elections. So there are places where unless the intention of your vote is to send an explicit message, I want the margin to be so big, I'm going to vote like X. If that's not your intention, if that's not your great and terrible reason to vote, and that you're just worried who's going to win, who's going to lose, look at the recent electoral history of your state and do a little bit of math.
Matt, because, yes. I love you, and I could talk to you for an hour. I mean it. I love this conversation, but I got to pay the bills. Capitalism once again, brother, hoisted by our own petard. Thank you. Please promise to come back.
You betcha. Love it. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. 312-642-5600.
From AM 560 to the campaign trail, Steve Cortez is on special assignment with the Trump campaign. But don't worry, he'll be back after the election right here on AM 560. The Answer.
Now that you're spending more time around the house, have you noticed that maybe a few things are needy?
Call Crumweedy!
Crumweedy Home Pros. There's no better investment than your home, and Crumweedy is open, doing proposals and booking jobs. Get a virtual consultation. It's easy, and we'll show you everything about your project from the comfort of your home. How it looks, what it costs, everything. This is a great time to
call Crumweedy!
Siding, windows, and roofs. All with no money down, no payments, and no interest for 18 months. And there's more. Half-price installation on siding, windows, and roofs.
Hey, Sean Hannity here. Call the exterior experts, Crumweedy, Mark Olson and Greg Olson of Crumweedy, a third-generation family business that's been doing Chicagoland exteriors now since 1953. It's all about trust, and they truly share your values.
If your home is needy,
call Crumweedy!
630-595-8020. Or just remember, homeisneedy.com. Homeisneedy.com. Crumweedy Home Pros.
Recent events have reminded us how fragile the stock market and your life savings can be. What would happen to you if you lost 30, 40, 50% or more in the market? It could likely destroy your quality of life and impact your plans for the future. Let this be a wake-up call to sit down and review your financial situation. Take control of your future today and call Wealth Management Group, 833-WMG-PLAN, or visit investwithwmg.com. All investing involves risk, including loss of principal. Securities and advisory services offered through LPL Financial, a registered investment advisor, member FINRA SIPC.
We know that sometimes it might be difficult to hear AM 560, like when you drive under that bridge, or you get too close to power lines, or when you're surrounded by gigantic concrete and steel buildings, which is why we've made it easy to listen to us whenever you want, wherever you might be. We're always streaming at 560theanswer.com and on the AM 560 mobile app. You can also get us on your Alexa-powered smart speaker, and we're on TuneIn, iHeart, and Radio.com. You can listen wherever and whenever to AM 560, The Answer.
Officer suspensions. Good evening. It's 80 degrees in Chicago at 6:30. On AM 560, The Answer, I'm Tom Beck. Seven police officers in Rochester, New York are suspended in connection with the death of a black man. Body camera footage showed Daniel Prude was handcuffed while naked on a street. A covering was put over his head. An officer shoved his face into the ground for several minutes. He died a week later from asphyxia, excited delirium, and PCP intoxication, according to the medical examiner who ruled the death homicide. Joe Biden said if elected, he'll create a White House Police Violence Commission. While visiting Kenosha this afternoon, Biden said he understands the frustration in communities of color about police brutality. He spoke by phone with Jacob Blake, the Kenosha man who was left paralyzed after being shot by a police officer. The shooting led to violent protests in Kenosha. Vice President Pence today said police departments won't be defunded while President Trump is in office, and he said law and order would be brought back to American cities. On AM 560, The Answer, I'm Tom Beck.
Friends, it's Steve Cortez here. Let's talk about mortgages and the housing market. The housing market has been an incredible bright spot within the economic recovery of recent months as our country begins to rebuild, quite literally in the case of home construction, and rebuild overall in terms of our economic renaissance from the ravages of the coronavirus. It seems quite clear that the housing sector is one of the leading drivers of that recovery. A lot of incredible data lately, including in July, the biggest month for existing home sales ever. And that's on the back of, in June, one of the biggest housing starts months ever. If you are in the mortgage market right now, I suggest you go to unitedfaithmortgage.com. They are wonderful people, family-run operation. They're a direct lender, which means often you can get your loan processed faster and sometimes at a better rate. unitedfaithmortgage.com.
United Mortgage Corp, Melville, New York. NMLS number 1330. Ryan Vrecka, NMLS number 65233. For all licensing information, go to NMLSConsumerAccess.org.
If you're in HR, you're probably wearing a lot of hats. Recruiter, team builder, trainer, mediator, policymaker, and of course, paper pusher. But not anymore. Bamboo HR is the number one HR software for small and medium businesses. It manages all your employee data easily and automates countless tasks so you can focus on people, not paperwork. Bamboo HR frees you from spreadsheets so you can do your real job, creating a great place to work. If the data shuffle and paperwork mountain have you ready to hang up all your hats, you're ready for Bamboo. If you handle HR records and paperwork, Bamboo HR is a dream. Let us free up your time and put your days of pushing paperwork behind you so you can focus on the people and making your company a great place to work for everyone. Try PC Magazine's top pick for HR software free today. Just go to bamboohr.com/HR. This is a limited offer, only available to radio listeners at bamboohr.com/HR. That's bamboohr.com/HR.
When you're looking for a caring dentist and an experienced dental staff who'll treat you like family, then it's time to call Dr. Y at Oaklawn Dental LLC. Dr. Yerkes and his team will create a smile that you'll want to share with family and friends. Go to oaklawndentist.com for a complete list of services or call Oaklawn Dental for an appointment with Dr. Y at 708-424-5700. And for a limited time, get a $100 credit on your new account. Call 708-424-5700. Oaklawn Dental LLC for the smile you deserve.
The following is a paid political announcement.
Hi, I'm Dr. Willie Wilson. So many politicians are bought by special interests and major corporations instead of the citizens who elected them. I would not be bought. I would finance my own campaign in good faith to the voters of Illinois and promise to serve with integrity at all times. I'm asking for your support as I run for a U.S. Senator in 2020.
Paid for by Willie Wilson for Senate 2020.
Mattress Firm's Labor Day sale is going on now. Save up to $500 when you get a king bed for a queen price or a queen for a twin. Plus, get a free adjustable base when you spend $699 or more. Or save 50% on top-rated brands like Beautyrest, Serta, and Sealy. Shop now.
Stuck in traffic? We've got the answer. From the AM 560 Traffic Center.
On Chicago's south side, eastbound 79th Street is blocked between Anthony Avenue and the Chicago Skyway. It's due to a shooting investigation. If you're headed on the eastbound side of 8094, bumper to bumper from the tri-state on over to Indianapolis Boulevard. Now the inbound side of the Edens, hitting the brakes from Peterson down to the Kennedy Merge. Lake Hook Road down to the junction 24, outbound in 16. Kennedy outbound, 18 to the split, ditto in the express, 36 to the airport. Inbound from O'Hare, 41, 23 of that off the junction. Eisenhower outbound from the circle out to 390. That clocks in at 58 minutes. Coming inbound now at York Road, a crash off onto the shoulder. 390 back in at 54. Stevenson outbound, busy to Pulaski. Lakeshore Drive to 355-39. That's traffic. I'm Mary DeBatches. On AM 560, The Answer.
Now, your official weather forecast.
Clear skies expected overnight. We'll see an overnight low of 58. Mostly sunny and pleasant Friday. We'll reach a high Friday of 79. It'll be warm Saturday with sunshine and patchy clouds. Breezy in the afternoon. Saturday, we'll see a high of 84. I'm Drew Shannon on AM 560, The Answer.
Get the latest weather, traffic, and news updates online at 560theanswer.com.
This hourly segment is brought to you by CharlesEquipment.com. Keeping you powered up no matter what the conditions.
AM 560, The Answer.
Diamond in the back, some rooftop, digging the scene with a gangster lady.
I'll tell you, I don't know, it seems like the show goes by faster and faster. It really does. I got to figure out how to muscle another hour out of somebody here. We're going to go to your calls, 312-642-5600. Joe, Villa Park. Joe, thanks for calling.
Oh, you're welcome. I would challenge any Biden supporter that you know, clearly state and support a policy that Joe Biden has. Besides, I hate Trump. If they could actually pick a policy that Biden has.
If they can, they're the real deal Marxist, brother, because every policy he has is an absolute iron grip over everything. This guy's talking about absolute and total communist healthcare, absolute and total communist education system. You know, here's the other thing. What do you mean you're going to pay for everybody's student loan? What about the suckers that paid their loan? I mean, their idea of fair is so unfair. It is frightening to me. And when you look at his financial plan, I'm going to tell you something right now. There's no, I got a little inside knowledge. For the last six, seven weeks, these hedge funds, these are the guys that really make the world go round. They're on the sidelines. And you remember what happened with Obama? You know how much money accumulated on the sidelines because they didn't want to jump in? They didn't know what was going to happen or how they were going to be taxed? That's how the government grew. And he did what was almost unimaginable, which is double the debt. And now what do you think is going to happen if Biden gets in? It's crazy what's happening. Thank you very much, Joe, for the phone call. If you can name, that's the real game. If you can name a Biden policy, you're a Marxist. All right. Kevin on the north side. How are you, Kevin?
Fine, thanks. Sean, how you doing?
Good, good. I'm better looking than Dan, and I'm not quite as eloquent. But other than that, go ahead.
I'm with CPD. I've been there 13 years, and let me tell you, I was in the NATO 2012, and we dealt with a group called Black Bloc, which was a left wing. And we got to get a hold of this, you know, us Republicans. Mm-hmm. Got to change the narrative that you're trying to push through the media, through all these pre-articles, and change the narrative that, you know, it's right-wing agitators, aggressors on this. All these protesters are left wing, and they've been that way since the inception of the George Floyd riots, even Barack Obama, you know, he had all these riots and all these incidents happen on his watch. Yet nobody wants to talk about that.
Kevin,
spices the vision, you know.
I'm interested in your opinion. I agree with you, number one, but I'm interested in your opinion. In my opinion, the best thing that could happen for Trump, and really, I think it's what brought him this close to the lead Biden had, and I think it will carry him to the victory in the same way it did Nixon in the early 70s. I think the best thing, absolutely, the best thing Republicans could do is let the chaos go on, let the police handle it, and stay out of it with the pickup trucks with the Trump flag. I think that's the worst thing they could do. I think the kid that, even though the intentions are good, and the intentions are to help, and the intentions are to do, you know, to show force or whatever the case is. The best thing for Trump victory is if the Republicans just stay back and let them live in their own failure. What do you think?
Yeah, I completely agree. I'm all for peaceful protests, you know, calm mm-hmm. heads and everything. But just this agitation has gone to the next level, and just the visceral that they're showing on the streets, just, you know, it's uncontrollable. It's just a boiling point waiting to happen.
All right. Police,
you know.
Yep. Kevin, listen, if you ever get in a gym, I got a nephew who's a sergeant. You just let me know. Thank you, Kevin. I'm kidding. I wasn't going to do this Chicago. I got a guy. I'm joking. Don't get nervous. Candace, Mount Pleasant, how are you?
Hey. I was going to tell you that last night I went to this event. Usually there's 20 to 30 women there for South.
I like
East
the sound
DOC
of this
women.
So far. Go ahead.
Okay. Are you ready for the number?
Mm-hmm.
200 women.
Really? Or any of them? Now, you're in Wisconsin?
Shocking.
How many size 16 and bigger jeans were up there?
Shut up. I'm just saying that is shocking.
All right.
They're the real wake up among women, these working women with their degrees and stuff.
And I'm going to tell you, yeah, and plus they're living in it. It's
because they like their houses. They spend a lot of time on their houses they don't want to mess with or taken away from them.
Now, you said,
there's no insurance.
Do you remember when you called me 2 months ago? You said you went door knocking, and you didn't like what you saw. Are you a little more optimistic now?
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes.
All right,
yes.
Cheer up about it, will you?
Yep.
My word. It was
yep.
like pulling teeth. Thank you very much, Candace. I really
Bye.
Appreciate it. And, you know, this is what happens when you witness the failure. See, I said before, for us in Chicago, Illinois, we're used to being on the down. We're used to understanding that the corruption, the failure, the taxation, the penalties, the this and that, raising in costs for everything from red light cameras to taxes on different licenses. We're used to that. Rest of the world isn't. We have to do what we can to make sure the Chicago Mafia way of politics doesn't leak into the real world. And this is where we make the fight. And I'll tell you another thing that's been really, I don't know how much time we got. We got enough time for me to play one of these clips? The thing that's really bothered me is the Chicago way of voting, the Chicago manipulation and corruption in the voting. I really was optimistic and hopeful that it wouldn't spread throughout the country. I am disgusted with the push and the acceptance of the true failure in any system where you do have indiscriminate voting and no way to audit, check, or regulate it. I really don't like the idea that we're going to open up mail system. I like absentee ballots because you have to apply for it. They have to accept it. I really was hoping that it would get squashed. I'm a little confused as to where it's being accepted and where it's being rejected, but I do like Barr on Wolf Blitzer. I have time or I got to go to break? All right, I want to play just clip one.
James Baker said back in 2009 that mail-in voting is fraught with the risk of fraud and coercion.
But since then,
until this administration, they haven't proved it. Let me talk.
Yeah, please.
And since that time, there have been in the newspapers, in networks, academic studies saying it is open to fraud and coercion. The only time the narrative changed is after this administration came in. But elections that have been held with mail have found substantial fraud and coercion. For example, we indicted someone in Texas, 1,700 ballots collected from people.
1,700 ballots, one guy. That's not small. Times that through as many people with bad intentions and the possibility of how you change the course of history through allowing this fraud. 312-642-5600. We'll be back with your calls, and you got to get in. We only got one more segment left.
AM 560's Steve Cortez is on special assignment working on President Trump's reelection campaign. He'll be back after the election in November right here on AM 560, The Answer.
Are your employees happy with the benefits you're offering them? Do you want to hang on to the best employees in 2021? Now's the time to review what you've been doing and see if there's something better. There is. I'm Jim Lorenz. I'm the owner and a fellow AM 560 listener, designing the best benefit packages for companies for over 30 years. Let's talk benefits. Of course, there isn't a single solution to this complex situation, and 60 seconds isn't enough time to tell you all of your options. Clear Insight has a streamlined approach to identify opportunities within your current plan, and we make it easy to implement the options you choose. Let me do the heavy lifting for you. You've got enough to deal with right now. If your employees are important to your business and you want to keep them and save money, Clear Insight Benefits is here to help. Let's set up a go-to meeting or a call at clearinsightbenefits.com. There's not much time left to prepare yourself for a successful 2021. Visit clearinsightbenefits.com.
Napa Know How.
At Napa, you can get a 5-quart jug of Mobil 1 full synthetic motor oil for $26.99. An incredible oil for an unbeatable price from the best car people around. Making this deal the best of the best of the best of the best of the best deals around. That's Mobil 1, only $26.99. Quality parts, helpful people. That's Napa Know How.
Napa Know How.
General States pricing. Sales prices not include applicable state, local taxes, or recycling fees. Offer ends 9/30/20.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
There's no better feeling than grilling out, and there's no better place than Ace to get the best grill for you and your family. We have the hottest grills from top brands like Big Green Egg, Traeger, and Weber. And since our stores are locally owned and we're committed to helping our neighbors, we'll also assemble and deliver your grill for free. Around the block, what you need in stock with people who know their grills. Offer valid for Ace Rewards members through September 7th on grills and accessories $3.99 and up. See participating stores for scheduling or exclusions.
In these challenging times, what is really happening? Is there a force behind it all? If you believe in the freedoms that founded America, if you're looking for answers, go to ProfitToAmerica.com. That's ProfitToAmerica.com. And download the free book, A Fresh Wind. Is God using this pandemic to bring us back to our roots? Go to ProfitToAmerica.com. That's ProfitToAmerica.com.
Small businesses are the backbone of America, and there's a lot we can learn from them. Listen to Building America and hear some of the most successful business owners and entrepreneurs across the Midwest discuss their challenges, successes, and pursuit of the American dream. Join David Bolanos every Sunday afternoon at 4:30 as he dives into what it takes to achieve the American dream. Go online to buildingamericanow.com to learn more and request to be featured on the show. Building America, Sunday afternoons at 4:30 right here on AM 560, The Answer.
AM 560, The Answer.
Shaft, John Shaft. Love it. 312-642-5600. We have two lines open.
Who could vote, he made them out and voted for the person he wanted to. Okay?
Because
that kind of thing happens with mail-in ballots, and everyone knows
that. But there are individual cases, but as far as widespread fraud, we haven't seen that since...
We
1700, that's not
wide. Widespread use of mail-in ballots is being proposed. We've had absentee ballots from people who request them from a specific address. Now what we're talking about is mailing them to everyone on the voter list when everyone knows those voter lists are inaccurate. People who should get them don't get them, which is what has been one of the major complaints in states that have tried this in municipal elections. And... people who get them are not the right people. They're people who have replaced the previous occupant, and they can make them out. And sometimes multiple ballots come to the same address with a whole several generations of occupants. Do you think that's a way to run a vote?
We're arguing over an obvious flaw. It's obvious. It's a bipartisan obvious flaw. Why would people argue for more room for more fraud unless they wanted to fraud it? Tom. Midlothian.
Hey, Sean. And that's exactly my point. That's what I was calling in about. We got an apartment above our office. I've got two ballots for guys that haven't lived there in over 12 and 24 months.
Vote how you think.
I know where
like
these guys are, but, you know, I mean, we're not going to use them, you know, because.
Tom, that's because you have that's because you have integrity. How many Americans don't, brother? This is, they're licking their chops at the idea they get to steal somebody else's vote and sway an election the way it shouldn't go. It is frightening, and it has to stop, Tom. I can't believe in America, the year 2020, we are so far down this prairie path. It's outrageous to me. But I want to thank you so much for the call. We have is this another time? Tom, another time. Tom, how are you? Thanks for calling.
Yes, Sean, I need to correct you. The politician, the socialist that you're referring to.
Colburn.
Colburn. I think it's James Clyburn of South Carolina.
Yeah, I couldn't think of it when I was gone.
He's the one that got Biden to be the nominee for the socialist.
And if you look at that district, he owns it. He is the boss hog of that district. He says jump, and the next thing you hear is how high. So, you know, it's like voting in these mafia neighborhoods around Chicago. How do you think they vote in Madigan's district? Any way he says. You know, I'm from Melrose Park. They stuck in this state rep, Kathleen Willis. Nobody heard of her. The order came down, and this 320-pound Volkswagen impersonator got in. And she's the number one person in Illinois going after the Second Amendment. So these are scary things when that happens, brother. And, you know, Tom, thank you, by the way, for correcting me. I appreciate it. We don't have time for Tom on the South Side. Tom on the South Side, Mary, Al, I am so sorry. You call back tomorrow because this is going to keep going. We're going to put up this fight till it's over. And if it's over and we lose, we're going to fight even harder. This is what you fight for, your freedom, for your liberty, for America. That's what's at stake. That's what we're fighting for. And we will win.
Final 100.